Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss on the mobile application development. This is one of the new subjects in the current trend, mobile application development. As everybody is aware of the mobile applications and mobile devices, what you are using, we also call them as the handheld devices. And these mobile devices is going to work in the end, not only for the calling the persons, but it will also work with you for browsing the internet and for creating your own applications and accessing your personal information from the databases and from bank accounts and all kind of places. So the mobile application development is a new platform, as I said, and in this platform we are going to learn one of the tool, what we call is the Android Studio. Android Studio is the one tool we are going to learn, and this Android Studio is called IDE, Integrated Development Environment. In this you can code the Java applications and then create the APK files using this IDE. So Android Studio is meant for only the Android handheld devices, that means Android mobile devices. If you want to create the mobile applications for the iOS devices, you need to use Xcode and Object-C. These are the tools where you can develop the applications in that area. And similarly, if you want to use the mobile application development for the Windows embedded, then you need to use the tool called Visual Studio and C#, C++, or other kind of tools you need to use. So our primary concentration is on the Android devices. So what we are going to do is, we are going to create Android based applications on which using this Android Studio IDE, and then we will run them and see how it is going to looks like in our day-to-day operations. So as I said, Android Studio is one tool where it is going to create the user interface for the mobile application. Okay, so in this mobile applications you have certain, if you take, this is your mobile phone, smart mobile. Okay, if you say this is your smart mobile, this smart mobile has a screen area of this much. Okay, and in this screen area your application should fit, so that can be automatically taken care by Android Studio when you create the applications. So in this you have the view, this is called the view area, and then you have the buttons, okay, for the volume, buttons for the turn on and off and other kind of stuff. Excuse me. So when we create these applications, okay, the application's first point is, what we have is activity. The first point in the Android Studio, Android application, is the activity. Activity is nothing but one kind of operation. Activity is nothing but one kind of operation where you are going to perform to see your user interface on this device, on this mobile device. So that user interface can be created using the functionality called activity. In this activity, you create front-end displays, you create front-end buttons, you create front-end grid, you create so many icons, so many items you can keep in this front-end. And once this activity part is finished, you can align all the elements inside the view in a proper way so that the look and feel of your user interface application created by this Android Studio will look in a very pleasurable way, so that you can operate it or others can operate your applications. So once you finish the work with the activity, then you go for the notifications. Notifications. Okay, so before coming to the notifications, we also have one part called services. So what is this services? Services is nothing but one entity, a part of this activity and other components. These services will run backend. So here I would like to bring to you one information. If you are aware of the software SDLC, software development life cycles, okay, in that we have all the phases of the software development. We use the same phase here and develop the applications. So when you create the applications are in three parts. One is user interface, then middleware, and the third part is backend. Okay, user interface, that is the front end, middleware, and backend. Front end is we are creating with the activity, and middleware is we are creating with the services, and the backend is with the database. So the services is going to play a big role in taking your request from the activity and then processing it, then sending to backend database. So like this, the application is created using activities, services, and then we also have another component, notifications. So what is this notifications? Notification is nothing but, one example I can bring it to your notice is that when you use WhatsApp, right? When you use WhatsApp or Messenger, if there is a message for you, you will get prompted. So that kind of information is called the notification. Notification is nothing but whenever there is a message alert is there for you, then that message will be pop up in a small box, and that is we treat them as notifications. Notifications can happen among the applications or in the applications and bring a hint for you that there is some message available for you, similar to WhatsApp and other things. You can see Telegrams also, you see the message notifications. WhatsApp, you see message notifications. Messenger, you see message notification, and all other applications nowadays, whatever you are creating. So all these applications what we are creating should have the notification functionality. Okay, then we have broadcast and receivers. Broadcast and receivers. So broadcast and receivers is nothing but sending the message to all the recipients. Okay, one example here is, if you are watching the TV at home, right, you will have only the antenna or set-up box, and you will get lots of channels in that one. That means they are broadcasting and you are receiving. Okay, so that is broadcast is nothing but spreading the message or sending the message from one source to many destination points. The many destination points can be your users, or user accounts, or user systems. All these can get the data whatever you are broadcasting. And the receiver is nothing but taking the back acknowledgement. Broadcast and receivers. Receiver is nothing but the message what you are sending is acknowledged back to you that I got your message whatever you are sending. So broadcast and receiver will work for you to communicate among your applications or among many applications. So it is also used between inter-process communications. That means between the two applications, you can use this broadcaster receivers functionalities. Okay. So the broadcaster receiver functionality will help you, that functionality with the help of intents. So intent is one object that is getting created, and that object will help you for sending, formulating the message, and for creating the message and then sending the message to the recipient. And similarly, this intent object will also help you in gathering the information from different recipients as the acknowledgement, and will give you the status. Okay. And then we have another one is the database. So you remember, every software application should have the functionality for database. Database is meant for storing the information from users' collection. Whatever you are collecting through this user interface, UI part, that information has to be processed through service and then sent to the database. Database, it will store the information in the form of tables which has rows and columns. In the form of table which has rows and columns. So this data is going to be stored. Why we need to store? Because today whatever you are creating this information in the UI part, and that if you want to save for future, usage you can save in the database. So here I would like to bring three different types of storage. One is flat file, and other one is tables, and another one is shared memory, shared preference. These are the three parts where your data, which is entered through user interface, can be saved. So when you are saving in the flat file is nothing but your normal text files, comma based or separator. So the data is getting separated, comma based. And tables is nothing but you can use SQL, SQLite, Oracle, whatever the database present available in the market, it is MySQL. All these are going to have this tables and rows concept. And then we have shared preferences. Sometimes the data will not be in the rows and columns. It is not in the text. It will be in the images. So such data you have to access and store through shared preferences. Shared is nothing but you are allocating a system folder. In that folder, all these data will be, images will be located, placed there, and that can be shared for the viewers, whoever is viewing your data. So this is the concept of database handling. Okay. In the database handling, as I said, the data has to be properly filtered and then sent to the tables. What do you mean by the filter? Filter is nothing but you cannot enter the data as it is. We need to give some indexing for that one. We need to give some identifications. What data is coming from whom? So the identification, because like you, there are so many mobile users who are using this application. Is this coming from the mobile one, or is the data coming from the mobile two, or is the data coming from the mobile N? That means user N. Whoever is using that one, that has to be addressed. Then only you can take your data and retrieve it back. Otherwise, if all this data is inserted without any proper identifications, then it will become a clumsy, and when you view, you may not view your data, you may view some other's data, which is wrong for your applications. So all these are the internal components which are going to work in the Android applications, and the Android Studio will address all these parts. So when we create an application using the Android Studio, it is going to create a file name with xyz.apk. What is this xyz.apk? xyz is nothing but your file name, and .apk. APK is nothing but, okay, Android format, where the compiler or the whoever is that using that, they can see this APK is nothing but it is a embedded application, and that embedded application can be viewed with a special privileges, because this application will not run on your laptop. Why? It has to have its supported formats, supported libraries, and other required functionalities to view these applications. So when you run this application on this Android platform, Android mobile, yes, it is going to understand what is the APK. Then it will load along with your application all the related libraries, and then you can properly view your applications. Okay, so this is what the file it is going to create. Okay, so when this is creating the functionalities, all these functionalities are compiled and then created with the .apk. Now, as we said, we are creating all type of applications using the Android Studio 2, that is IDE, Integrated Development Environment 2. So what type of applications we can create? Can we create a web-based applications? Can we create a personal information applications? Or can we create a generic applications? Basically, we need to remember the mobile applications are 99.99% we use for personal. 99.99% we use for our personal usage. That's why whenever you create your mobile applications, you should see that you are creating for a particular customer who is distributing to his some customers. So you need to see that it is a personal information management, PIM, personal information management. Okay. So with this, I am going to stop here. So students, please go through this, all the information, whatever is given here. And if you have any questions, you can get back to me. Thank you.